Welcome to all newly admitted students in first year travel and tourism for first semester. And today I am going to introduce you a new subject, that is introduction to tourism industry. It's a basic subject of travel and tourism diploma, and you will be going to learn shortly all the aspects of tourism industry which are the important. In this subject, we will be going to cover all the aspects. What is meant by tourism? Who is a tourist? Who is a traveler? Who is an excursionist? What is the definition of tourism? That everything we will be going to learn in this subject one by one. In this semester, you have to learn this subject not only for the examination, but this is the such kind of subject. This is the fundamental knowledge of tourism industry. And in this curriculum, we will be going to cover like who is travel agent, what is hotel industry, what is airline industry, what is cruise, and important thing is we will be going to learn from what are the job opportunities and why the training is necessary for the human, and what is the importance of the training, what types of hotels are there, what kind of mode of transportation is there. You may be aware about the air travel. Someone have the experience of traveling by air, some may have no experience, but don't worry, in upcoming future you will definitely travel by air also. So there may be a procedure for traveling by the air, checking procedure, checkout procedure, that we will be going to learn. You may be visited some of the tourist places in India or outside the India with your parents, or tour organized by your college or your school during your education life. In the hotel, when we reach the hotel, that time check-in procedure is there, check-out procedure is there. There are different kinds of category of the hotel. Non-star hotel, that is economical class standard hotel. Then deluxe hotel, standard hotel, super deluxe hotel, luxurious hotel, one-star hotel. The categorization has been done by Government of India, Ministry of Tourism. In Mumbai, there is an office, Ministry of Tourism, near Churchgate railway station. The committee, they have the gradation criteria, 1-star, 2-star, 5-star. They have the hotel people, they approach them, they fill the form, and according to them, the committee will visit, they do a recognition for that hotel, particular hotel. They will assign the grade, 1-star hotel, 2-star hotel. Then what is the difference between the 1-star hotel and 2-star hotel? That we will be going to learn. There are different kinds of mode of transportation, traveling, transportation by road, by train, by air, by waterways, and there are different classes are there. There are different kinds of trains are also there. The Rajdhani trains, Shatabdi Express, Vande Bharat. There are different kinds of trains are there. Normal passenger train is there. In for the local transportation in Mumbai, local train is there. Monorail is there. Metro train is there. So we have to understand, toy train is there. There are different kinds of luxury trains like Deccan Odyssey in Maharashtra, Palace on Wheels in Rajasthan. And they have different kinds of fares. They have different kinds of fare facilities are there in the train. So what is the difference between the first class AC and three-tier AC? What is the difference between the Rajdhani train and Shatabdi train? What is the difference between the Garib Rath Express and other train? So that fare difference we must know. What kind of facilities and services available for the passenger in that train, we must know. When we know, then we will inform to the tourist. When you will be going to sell a tourist package, that you must know each and everything of the transportation. So transportation is very, very important component of tourism industry. Accommodation is also very, very important component of the tourism. Without transportation, without accommodation, we cannot plan a tour. So both are the very, very important component of tourism industry, and that we will be going to learn in details. Then there are different kinds of types are there. Why people travel? अभी आप लोगों ने travel किया होगा कभी? Why we travel? Why someone will be going to visit in particular destination? What is the motivation behind the traveling? That we will be going to learn. Someone is traveling for the sport. Someone is traveling for the pilgrimage purpose. Someone is traveling for the business purpose. So what is the purpose behind the traveling? What is the motivation behind traveling? That we will be going to learn. And on that basis, there are types of tourism. There are some upcoming new varieties are there that we will be going to learn. Like someone is traveling for the pilgrimage, that is pilgrimage tour, adventure tourism, business tourism, MICE tourism, agriculture tourism, rural tourism. There are different kinds of tour packages are there, types of tours are there, that we will be going to one by one, going to learn one by one. Medical tourism is there. So medical tourism is also very, very important. So we will be going to learn all the types of tourism in this subject. So these types are very, very important for you in when you going to plan in a, when you will be learn in during the semester 5th or 6th, that time during your training also this subject will be useful. You can categorize the destination in the types of that particular place. For example, Shirdi, in which category? For example, we are visiting Mumbai, in which category? We are visiting Kanpur, that will be that place in which category of types of tourism? That we have to understand. And we will be going to plan a tour according to need of the tourist. What is the interest of the tourist? Interest is very, very important. When you are watching this video, your interest is important. If you are not interested, you will not acquire knowledge 100%. So interest is very, very important. Sometime what happen, you are interested to doing IT engineering, but due to the low percentage, you have not satisfied with college sometimes. You are not satisfied with the branch which is available during the admission process. So again you are not interested for particular that, but if you are interested, then no issue. Otherwise you have to create interest. When tourist will visit particular places, as a tour manager, as a tour guide, as a tour escort, I have to create interest in a tourist mind. Interest is very, very important. Motivation is very, very important. You have to motivate people. If you visit any movie, or if you going to watch a movie in particular theater, that time you can see, you know, during the interval there are different kinds of trailer they show. Generally we see the trailer, and from that trailer we decide this movie is good. So such kind of trailer you have to prepare, and you have to create image of that particular destination in the tourist mind. We have to show a trailer of the tour package, and rest tourist will be going to visit at particular destination. In tourism industry, you have to be alert, you have to be presence of mind, you have a knowledge of each and everything. So this is introduction to tourism industry subject that will be focused on your communication skill also. Because how to communicate as a tour guide, as a tour escort, as a tour manager, that is important. What kind of qualities and skill and knowledge is required when you work in a travel and tourism industry? We will be going to learn communication skill, leadership quality. That is very, very important. When you lead as a leader of the group, that is very, very important. You have each and every knowledge. So don't worry, we will cover. Welcome to first year. The series of the online video I will be going to share on your WhatsApp group, on YouTube channel, and on my Google Drive. Don't worry, I will clear your all doubts. You can send me a message, you can call me, or you can ask me any doubts on WhatsApp group also. So we will start one by one topic. I will assign some assignments also. So we will evaluate that assignments, so I come to know what is your progress also. Okay, so this is thank you. This is the introductory lecture for this subject, and you must understand the importance of this subject also. So thank you very much. Thank you.